Bootylicious!
Yes, Your Honor?
Your witness.
Yes, Your Honor. Mr. Bannon, how long have you known the boys?
Why, 4 years. Almost half their...
Fascinating. Tell me, Mr. Bannon, what do you have to say about... this? Sorry. Tell me, Mr. Bannon, what do you have to say... Oh, God. I thought I had this right. No, let's see. No, I tried that one already.
What do you have to say about this?
Mr. Birdman, you better have a damn good explanation for this.
I do, Your Honor. A few months ago, during the adventure of the sunken safe deposit box, Race mysteriously became left-handed, and his shoes suddenly had laces when, up till then, they'd always been slip-ons. See, the bartender that gave Race a drug frozen lime daiquiri during the House of Tasteful Men was the same man who Judge later dinged your Lexus and drove off without exchanging insurance information. This man created a robot, Race Bannon, and programmed it to get the boys. And that man, Your Honor, is in this very courtroom. Stenographer, read back what I just said.
Yes. Something about a Lexus and, slip-on shoes and... Oh, drat! This confounded machine doesn't make any sense!
Zin.
Quickly, to the vulture craft!
That ain't right.
Tell us, officer, did you find any incriminating material in the van?
Affirmative. Yes.
Such as?
5-6 pizza boxes. Eye drops, some clips.
You mean this young lady's hairpins? You'll have to do better than that, officer.
There was this incense. Jamaican love.
And I might add, if we were to arrest everyone who's in possession of this product, there'd be a heck of a lot fewer people Jamaican love tonight.
So, you are a musical group, correct?
Yes.
No.
Oh, for God's sakes.
You, the shark. No more from you today, okay?
Who writes your music?
Someone with something yummy in his tummy?
Those guys over there, they're gonna lose this one. Pretty sure of it. No, I know it.
And before you answer this next question, I'll remind you that you swore on a Bible to tell the truth here today. So tell us, and God, where the song Lovely Lovely came from. He'd like to know.
We don't know.
Nothing further.
I'd like to call Yogi Bear to the stand.
He was a good little bear, until the park got a corporate sponsor.
Mr. Yogi,
can you tell us the title of this book?
Hey, I'm not much of a reader type.
Well, no matter, just tell us the title.
I can't read.
And tell us, can your friend Boo-Boo, can he read?
I don't think so.
There. It's gonna be all right.
You know what I say? Gandhi is dandy, but liquor is quicker. Ha ha! Quicker.
I see.
Mrs. Flintstone, would you say your husband gets hit on the head a lot?
Define a lot.
A lot. A great deal. More than once by a bunch.
I really couldn't tell you.
I'm holding records from Bedrock County Hospital, which indicate that your husband was admitted on 47 separate occasions last year for, and I quote, severe head trauma as a result of bowling ball mishap. And once for getting his head stuck in a milk bottle?
He's a little clumsy.
Indeed. And isn't it true that at these times he often descends into a delusional state, sometimes actually adopting another person's persona?
No, that's not true.
I'll remind you, you're under oath. Your Honor.
Yes, you may roll it. Mind taker.
Who is this?
My husband.
Correction. Before getting bonked on the head by a bowling ball, it was your husband. Now it's Frederick, the international bon vivant and playboy. And this?
My husband.
No! Bowling ball! Bonk! Surprise! It's Federico Flintstone, international race car driver and playboy. And tell me, Mrs. Flintstone, who is this?
That's Cary Grant.
But who's he talking to?
My husband.
Wouldn't it be safe to say that your husband, for a time, after so many concussions, perhaps thought he was a mob boss but really wasn't?
It's possible, yes.
Nothing further.
Who is the man in the suit?